नमस्कार डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग इनवर्स ट्रिगोनोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस एंड टुडे इट इज जेईई ट्रबल शूटिंग सेशन. ओके, सो दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम. इफ साइन इनवर्स एक्स प्लस साइन इनवर्स वाई प्लस साइन इनवर्स जेड इक्वल्स टू पाई, देन एक्स इंटू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई इंटू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस जेड इंटू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ वन माइनस जेड स्क्वायर. We have to find out the right, correct choice. Now, first of all, see sin inverse x equals to alpha, sin inverse y equals to beta, sin inverse z equals to gamma, where we know that alpha, beta, gamma belongs to range of sin inverse that is closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. From that, we can say x equals to sin alpha, y equals to sin beta, z equals to sin gamma. So, we know that cos alpha equals to square root of 1 minus sin square alpha. So it is square root of 1 minus x square. Similarly, cos beta equals to square root of 1 minus y square and cos gamma equals to square root of 1 minus z square. See, this is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So it is either fourth quadrant or first quadrant. In both the quadrants, cos is positive. So I have taken as it is. Okay. Now, what is the key idea to solve this problem? Okay, because they have given x into square root of 1 minus x square. So it is obvious that it is sin alpha into cos alpha. Now if we multiply sin alpha into cos alpha by 2, it will become sin 2 alpha. That means we can convert this we can say this as 1 upon 2 into 2 sin alpha. Similarly, this is 1 upon 2 into 2 sin beta. Similarly, this is 1 upon 2 into 2 sin gamma. That means we have to find relation of sin 2 alpha plus sin 2 beta plus sin 2 gamma with the remaining terms. Okay, or in simplification of that, sin 2 alpha plus sin 2 beta plus sin 2 gamma. Okay, so first of all, see, they have given alpha plus beta plus gamma equals to pi. So alpha plus beta equals to pi minus gamma. This is a relation we will use afterwards. Now sin 2 alpha plus sin 2 beta plus sin 2 gamma, I have explained you that we have to simplify it. So this can be written as s plus s 2 s c 2 sin alpha plus beta cos alpha minus beta. This is 2 sin gamma cos gamma. This alpha plus beta can be written as pi minus gamma. So it will become sin gamma again. So 2 sin gamma cos alpha minus beta plus 2 sin gamma cos gamma. Taking 2 sin gamma common, it will be cos of alpha minus beta plus cos gamma. Now again, gamma can be replaced as pi minus alpha plus beta. So I am replacing here gamma as pi minus alpha plus beta. Okay. So 2 sin gamma in bracket cos of alpha minus beta. Now see, this is second quadrant, pi minus. In second quadrant, cos is negative. So it is minus cos of alpha plus beta. Okay. So 2 sin gamma into, now see, cos alpha minus beta minus cos alpha plus beta. Okay, it is 2 sin alpha sin beta. Okay, normally we remember like this, c minus c equals to minus 2s. But in that case, the alpha plus beta should be ahead. But here alpha minus beta is ahead, so minus of minus will become plus. So it is 2 sin alpha sin beta. Okay, so now it is 4 sin alpha sin beta sin gamma. Thus we have proved, simplified, that sin 2 alpha plus sin 2 beta plus sin 2 gamma equals to 4 sin alpha sin beta sin gamma. Okay, now sin 2 alpha is 2 sin alpha cos alpha, sin 2 beta is 2 sin beta cos beta, sin 2 gamma is 2 sin gamma cos gamma equals to 4 sin alpha sin beta sin gamma. Putting the values, 2 sin alpha is x, cos alpha is root of 1 minus x square, plus 2 sin beta is y, and this is root of 1 minus y square. Into plus 2 into sin gamma is z, cos gamma is square root of 1 minus z square equals to 4 x y z. But we have to divide, because it is dividing both the sides by 2. Then it will become x into square root of 1 minus x square plus y into square root of 1 minus y square plus z into root of 1 minus z square equals to 2 x y z. Okay,